My name is Pepe. I am 40 years old. I'm from Spain. And it was my very first time that I signed up for a clinic. My dream was like doing a forward loop. I always thought that that was something that I was not gonna be able to reach it because I was already like 40 years old. So claiming for the forward loop was something like very, very challenging. I actually didn't think that I was gonna make it, but at least try and enjoy.
Oh, nice. Go on, son! Oh. Go on! Come
here! Have you tried any before?
No, not really. Only the back loop, and it was only half back loop because when I was up, freak out. And so if I couldn't even try the back loop, I didn't even think about the forward loop. That was too hectic. I've been windsurfing for almost 15, 20 years, but my learning curve was like this, and then you get stuck, and then you slightly improve small things. But nothing serious.
So the forward loop, you had a breakthrough. Was there one key thing that was a breakthrough? Was there anything that you went ding, or was there a couple?
Well, it's difficult to find only one, but I reckon that the main one was indeed when you really do the whole rotation, open your eyes.
That's fucking incredible. The only thing I had to do is what you fucking told me. I just follow you up, and oh my god!
Nothing happened to me, I'm one piece. That actually makes you like, wow, your brain is like getting more confidence, and then you definitely start like focusing on other steps that you need to do.
You went through your sails.
Look, with the forward loop, the first thing is you are very scared. You need to break that in your mind. The only way you can break it is just getting confidence. So you need to go like small little steps that make you to realize that nothing is gonna happen. So holding your hands tight to the boom is actually a key because normally you tend to release, then you don't improve because you bail on the movement before. Keeping your foot very inside the foot strap, it's actually a very key thing because then if you are holding the whole gear, it's almost going to happen by itself.
Did you film the forward?
Film what?
The forward!
What forward? No?
No!
No!
Oh,
another key thing for the forward loop, it's always try to go downwind because if you go upwind or you go straight, you have a lot of chance to like crash and don't do it. So going downwind to me was like the key thing. If you go downwind and you don't release the gear, then more likely nothing's gonna happen to you. Just hold it tight and
yes, 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 yes. That's not him. Yes.
When I did my very first good rotation, the key thing was that I really left the board to go out of the water, so I felt that I was completely in the air and then forced a lot. And that was just great. And everything happens like this, very quick. But then when you land, you are like, wow, so you rotated. Look, when you watch videos about forward loop and you want to learn how to do it, you always see guys doing like super high forward loops or like super radical forward loops. To me, one of the key was that Ben was in front of me and was like, hey Pepe, I'm gonna show you how to do it. Look, it's do like this. And he was doing forward with this little wave. And he was like, ah. So I don't really need to go for the big wave. I can do it with a small. That really opened your mind and say like, it's just a movement. When I was ready to jump, I was repeating on my head like, don't release, backhand, backhand, don't release, backhand, don't release, backhand. Then many other things come to your mind like, turn your head, keep the foot strap. What I did was like, put my feet very, very deep inside, so I knew I could forget about that. And before I jump, my backhand was like super back. Like normally they tell you back, super back, and then clap. Wait, that's all. We
escaped through the
When I was trying, I was starting to rotate and land on my back. So it was really harmful. So I really recommend you to have like a life jacket or a impact jacket that will help you a lot. And apart from that, you don't really like get hurt. As long as you are keeping your hands and your boom and your feet doesn't come off the foot trap. Not much light in the tunnel. Oh. Some people say that the forward loop is easier than back loop, and I thought like, nah, it can't be like that. But it actually is like that. Like back loop is much more technical, and you have more chance to fall on top of the board. So forward loop, once you do it, you realize that wow, it was there, and we didn't try, and it's much easier. So I would rather now go for a forward loop rather than a back loop.
You are fucking joking.
It's a matter of trusting you a little bit. Come on. Do you know who is Pepe the windsurfer?
No.
Do you know who is Pepe the windsurfer?
That's
a matter because Pepe is me, I can't tell you. Pepe the windsurfer. I was a shitty windsurfer, and then all of a sudden I signed up for a clinic with Colin and Ben, and now I'm like a super good windsurfer. At least I can do forward loop, can you?
Here we go, he's on. Ole, 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 ole.
Clinic is a completely unexpected experience because you think that you go there to learn, but you are like learning every single moment you are in or out of the clinic, because you are learning while you are in the water, learning when you are later watching the videos with the pillars, and also when you are in bed, like not being able to sleep, and then you are thinking and rethinking. So it's actually some good material for your mind that really opens your mind. But being in a clinic, to me, it's very important because when you have like a medium level average windsurfing skills, then you get kind of stuck. You improve, but very little. But with the clinic, it's like bam, 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 and then you actually open up for much more. There are a few ideas why you should sign up for a clinic. First of all, is the best way you force yourself to be only windsurfing during those days. Secondly, because you pay, you're really gonna go to do your best. Thirdly, you learn from the best. Fourth position is that you're gonna go with so many people that share your passion, so they all speak your same language. Another thing is that you are safe. So if something happens out there, you know there are people taking care of you, so they will care. That you don't have that when you go on your own. Another thing is that you get record every single movement you do. So then later you have those videos for you to share it with your people. Oh my God, that's like the best. You do your first forward loop, it's there, it's there. It's to me more important than when I did my first step when I was a child.
No, I got it.
Also that you can learn so much about watching your videos 1, 2, 3, I watch my first forward like 25 times or 30, or I will keep checking that. So there are plenty of ideas of why to sign up on a clinic, and I definitely encourage every single person to do it, because it's gonna be like a boost on your windsurfing level, and then after that, it's only enjoying after that. Go for it, man. Takes me away.
Beautiful, beautiful!
I'm only sure about one thing, is that whatever it happens outside, we are gonna have good fun.
We got a new baby to give away. Just for anyone who doesn't know, F2 are supporting windsurfing.tv this year. not only with a bit of finance, but they're giving away some cool products. And this is the first one we're going to give away. If you've been following, which you have been, you're the Windsurfing TV community, our exploits in Cape Town. We've been doing some coaching clinics, and we've definitely had a lot of standout guys, but one in particular has absolutely nailed it. And F2 gave me a ring and said, look, we want to help this guy out. We reckon he's a legend. We do too, so we're going to go and give him a new toy.
This is Paul from F2. And Mr. Paul from F2 has been following you on the TV Instagram, and he thinks you deserve a prize for going from zero to hero in the Ford loop.
No, thank you. You're kidding, right?
This is the new baby, Pepe's
new baby. No, baby, this is a joke, right? Is it for me? Once I take it in for me, eh?
Okay, not everyone that comes on a clinic wins a board, but that guy was a total legend and F2 spotted him, so big up to F2. I mean, you don't get better than that. He got a board that clinic week for his 40th birthday. He learned to loop zero to hero in 1 week and got given a board. I have to say though, we didn't ask him to do the sort of big up for the clinic. He was just so stoked with it, and I'm not bloody surprised. We do have a couple of spaces on the Cape Town clinic. We've had a couple of senders who have injured themselves before we actually got to teach them the right technique. So there's another reason you should book on. Two spaces left, I think. Email me coaching@windsurfing.tv, and I'll tell you what's available. Also, I've just moved to Portugal, so we will be doing clinics in Europe now. Going to kind of base from here, so we've got a few options. Tarifa's not far away, Canary's just a short pop away, so there's lots going on. If you want to get involved or get on the main list, coaching@windsurfing.tv. Also, the Christmas draw, everyone who supported the channel with the membership, the beer money, every £10 will give you a raffle ticket into the Christmas draw. We've got two pairs of Lips sunglasses. I'm going to give away a load of hats. We might even make some t-shirts and Southeast signage. Yes, Sam Lathan has chipped in €100 worth of sale graphics, or you know, sale numbers or anything like that, any sort of signage he's going to chip in. He's a keen windsurfer and he watches the channel. So there you go, that's it. Ho ho ho, Merry Christmas.